Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In this session, we will see if we have this electric room heater, how we can test, how we can troubleshoot using a series lamp. If you don't have multimeter, how we can troubleshoot it perfectly, and it is a very useful way to troubleshoot. When we connect multimeter to any conductor wire, any material, in continuity mode, one lead to this end, the second test lead to this end of the wire. The current from this lead flows through this conductor and it completes its circuit, and it gives us the resistance, it gives us the beep. The same way, how we can make this series lamp? Just only take a cable, any cable, power supply cable, cut one wire. So we cut and we install in the holder of this lamp. One wire that is coming from the cable enter here, and the second that is the test probe. And we are using tungsten lamp. It is 60 watt. We can use 60 watt, we can use 100 watt. This lamp is 100 watt. 60 watt, 100 watt. We can use this one or this one. For normal power supplies, electronic boards, we can use any one of these. I always use 100 watt, but it is also useful. What we do basically, when we are connecting these two points here, from this point to this point, neutral is coming here and it is reaching to the lamp one end. The second end, it is receiving the line voltage. If we are connecting from this point, and if we are connecting between two points, if there is any component, there is anything that will be tested. Basically, we are taking a path from that component. Special care in this series testing lamp, that here we have line voltage. We must take care that live voltage are here for that purpose. We must insulate ourselves from the ground. Our any body part should never touch to the ground, because if we will touch it here and we are grounded, we will take electrical shock. This is very dangerous safety point. But for series testing, if we are insulated, if we are isolated from the ground, we can use it without any problem. So let's start, and it is very easy and quick way to troubleshoot the fault. I will connect this power cable to the power socket. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair at yourself. Okay, I connect it. When we connect it here, we can see the lamp is illuminating full. And if I will connect to any load at that time, what will happen? The light, the intensity will decrease. If we are connecting to some heavy load, low resistance load, at that time it will fully bright like this. Here this time no load. And if we will place some load here, like you can see, this time it is dim. Maybe in the camera you can not differentiate, but visually we can see it. This time it is less bright. It is full bright, dim. How we can test power cable now? This is the power cable, and we will make complete troubleshooting for this heater. We will connect one lead to this input terminal, and it is reaching here. One lead that is reaching here at this terminal, when we are testing with series lamp, never touch to any component here. Now turn off the mod select and turn off the thermostat. Now we will check. It is illuminating at one end. That means these voltage are now reaching here and these reaching here. Our this switch is good. and we can test here the second lead that is coming here. The brown wire, the phase wire that is reaching to the thermostat, it is not giving continuity. So we will touch this wire here. Now we will touch to the input side of the thermostat. It is fully illuminating, that means this wire have good continuity. Now we verified that power cable, both leads, one lead is reaching here, the second lead is reaching here at this thermostat switch. Now connect to the second side. When we will connect to the second side, here we tested from this point to this point. Now I connected here, adjust the thermostat. So now we tested the thermostat. Thermostat is okay. Now we verified the power cable, both sides. The current is reaching here at these two points. Now we will leave the power cable and we will reach here in the entrance of the circuit. One entrance is here, the second entrance is here. One to the PTC switch and the second this adjustable thermostat. Now there is no light. Adjust the thermostat to some mid position or fully counterclockwise. Place this switch, mod selector, to first position. And we can see the fan is running now. This lamp is now not illuminating. Why? Because it is consuming low power. This time we applied voltage here. Our fan motor is now running from this point to this side. We connected one line to the PTC switch and it is reaching to the common line of the motor. We connected here, line we connected here, and it is reaching to the motor second end. Motor is running and the noon is turning on. You can see. Now we will move to position number one. The lamp is dim. The fan stopped. Why? Because we have two resistors in parallel. The load resistance, the heating element, and the motor are now in parallel. This is low resistance, so it is consuming all the voltage. It is not allowing much voltage to operate the motor. Move to the second position. The lamp is more bright. Less, more. From the intensity of the lamp, we can verify that when there is more current consumption in this heating element, so that is causing to produce a low resistance in this circuit. So that is why it is illuminating full, because in the path we have less load. Now we have more load and the lamp is illuminating full. Now I connected one lead here at the entrance. And now we will check one by one. This fan we verified. If we want to test the circuit, I will connect a pin and I will place to position number one. Now I connected one lead to the thermostat input side. And I placed this switch to the motor side. Now we will check continuity. We will check continuity at this terminal. So current is passing through thermostat and it is reaching here. Now we will move to position number one. At position number one, this blue wire, it will give full light. So that means our low side heater is receiving voltage. Now we will move to position number two. This time we will receive voltage at blue wire, we will receive voltage at yellow wire and black wire. Yes, full bright, and for the motor. In first position, just only fan will receive voltage. In the second position, fan and blue wire. In the third position, fan, low heat, full heat. These will receive voltage. Now how we can test this heating element? Turn off the switch. Turn off thermostat. The red wire, that is common wire, that is coming from this line. So we will connect one lead to this red side, and we have one input that is coming through selector, and that is coming through this selector. We will connect one by one. It is dim. If we will check this one, this is dim. If you make difference between these two, this is less bright, and if we select this one, it is much bright because we have low resistance in this line. The outer two plates, this one and this one, these heating bodies are for 1500 watt, and this center section, it is 500 watt. When we will connect in parallel at full heat, at that time it will produce 2000 watt. Special care while testing this heating element: never touch the outer body because it have the live voltage. Here we will receive full voltage, or we can test it separately as well. Just only remove from the selector switch, and now we have three wires, 1, 2, and 3. The third wire, that is common between the heating elements, 1, 2, 3, 4 sections. Just connect one lead to the common, second lead to this one. So we are testing these two, because this is common, 1 and 2. We are testing these two portions. If it is not giving indication, it is not giving continuity, that means our this heating set, heating element set, is damaged. Now test with this wire. This time we are testing the outer two, 1 and 2. And if you want to test full heat at that time, the light will change. Common at the same point, and this time we are applying these voltage to the both lines. So we can estimate by viewing the light that load is changing or not. But special safety point that it have unisolated voltage. You can use some isolated voltage isolation transformer, at that time you can work freely, but always take care. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.